Hello everyone, Supersonic Blue here, and welcome back to another GTA San Andreas, the definitive edition 100% guide here on the channel. So today, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be carrying on with the main missions. So we've only got this mission here with CJ at the moment. We obviously did that one with Zero. I'm glad I got that out of the way, all of Zero's missions. But anyway, yeah, let's just get cracking and see what's what.
Hey homies,
what up, Carl?
What the fuck is going on? Do I look like a hooker to you?
What?
Those assholes keep saying shit to me.
Who said this to you?
The construction workers up that hill.
I'ma fuck them up.
Nah, hold up. I got this. I need to go teach them a little respect.
Huh? That's right.
Yeah. I've been thinking about getting me some new land anyway.
Nice. Okay, this one can be a little irritating, but should be okay. I don't think they've a lot of it up. I need to steal a bulldozer. Watch the barrels. I just need to check something quickly before I start. So obviously, I did some more collectibles this week, and I did. Okay, my music volume's off. That's what's just checking. And I've done some more achievement guides as well. So, not achievement guides, activity guides. So, yeah. Nearly done with the oysters now. We've got 20 more to do. Damn it. Now there are the yes! You! Okay. Yeah, so I've not got long to do it. Mind the barrels. Oh yeah, they come out with me with another bulldozer. Get out of my way, son. So yes, this can be a little irritating because obviously they have people following you, and there's explosive stuff behind there as well. I think you can technically use the wrecking ball to finger, and they will try and pull you out, so that's something you've got to be wary of as well. This last one's always a pain in the ass to get because of where them barrels are.
What's all that damn clatter?
Okay.
Holy crap, I didn't see nothing.
Oh, what's happening back there? Things flying all over the sky. I don't think we've got time limit now. No. Oh god, oh god, oh no, oh god, oh god, let me. No, 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 you son of a. Sure it is. This is what I mean, they pull you out. Especially if it's always on that corner where I get stuck. Oh yeah, they've got pistols as well, but we should be okay. We got full health now. Now, this is the pain in the ass bit when you've got people shooting at you and then you've got this person here. Oh, go on, give. No, oh, you son of a. What the. He just became someone else.
Blame me, blame yourself.
Did someone fall down there? They did. Where did that other guy go? I don't know. Oh, it's side of me. Right, we're gonna have to do a little shimmy here. This is a robot wars, get away from me. Oh, I'm gonna get yanked out again. Okay. I will kill you. I'm gonna have to try and get rid of this guy. I think he's getting on my bleeding nerves.
Fuck out of here.
Right. Got him out of the way. My god, he was getting on my bloody nerves. Right, I'll get this thing out of the way. There's also a chainsaw around there from the older games. I can't remember if it's in that building or it's in that building. There's definitely, though, a chainsaw on here. I might find it, actually, while we're here. Which building is it? Is it this one over here? Ah, there it is. So, yeah, there's literally a chainsaw right behind CJ's garage. So, we will just grab that. If anyone gets anywhere near me, I'm going to slice them up. Right, so now we just back up this cement truck where it is there. And we're going to bury him alive. Careful not to damage it either. There we go. Because he can fail this mission by accidentally driving the cement truck in there. Okay, that's actually look more like cement. Nice. Okay. Cool. Now this is worth it. This is where the game gets interesting when we start doing this mission. Oh.
Jethro, what up?
Well, I was talking to Cesar and, don't get me wrong, dude. I mean, you are one out there dude when it comes to driving, man. But Cesar, he told us how many cars you get through, dude. And me and Dwayne were like, whoa!
What is your point, Jethro?
No point, man, no point. Just that there's an advanced driving school, like, just up the road from the garage, man. Like, ignore it.
Driving school? Man, exactly what you trying to say, man?
Nothing, man, nothing. It was Dwayne's idea. I think you're, you know, cool and shit. I better go, CJ. I'll see you later.
So, the driving school... when we do the driving school, we'll do it in the next video. We'll do this mission first, but we'll do the driving school. So basically, driving school is literally, you can see it right there, the S. Basically, once we do driving school and complete it all, we'll be able to buy Wang property here. This car showroom, we'll be able to buy that. At the moment it's red, which means we can't buy it. We need to do the driving school first. I don't think it's available straight away after we do the driving school, but basically what that then does is it opens up missions with Cesar hitting here at the garage, and basically we do that I think until we've gotten further in San Fierro. It won't happen yet, but I want to get the school out of the way pretty quick. So we'll do that in the next video, but we'll carry on next. I'll explain more in the next video. But we'll do this one.
You got it?
Hey, my cousin just called me. He gave me a tip about a baller's car going to San Fierro to score yay.
Shit. We gotta find out who's supplying those cats.
Read your mind, Holmes. I picked them up at the Mulholland intersection, and I'm trailing them now.
Okay, I'm coming to meet you.
Better make it fast, Holmes. These boys aren't hanging around.
I want his bike. So, Caesar's just here. He's by Blueberry. Should be able to... God damn it. And it's not highlighted again. Okay. This is another thing that needs to... If, you know, sometimes with the missions, they don't highlight on the GPS. So they were supposed to be making, obviously having the GPS to make it easier, but that's another thing I've noticed that doesn't happen all the time. Now locally I know my way around the map anyway, because I used to, obviously like I said, I used to play this as a kid, but I'm kind of at the moment just sort of regretting GTA 3 because I've played a bit of that. I've not played the whole thing, but I played a bit of that, and there was never any map or anything like that. So there is a map, which is good, but there was never actually a map in the old GTA, the classic GTA 3 game. So if, because they've now got, obviously they've added GPSs and maps to it, if the GPS doesn't work and I'm doing a mission, I'm not gonna know where I'm bloody going. That's why, I mean, I didn't like GTA 3 all that much, if I'm honest, but that was mainly because there was no map. So I didn't know where I was going. I don't think, there's the GPS. So it happens like really, really like late into your journey, but like I said, it's just a good job I actually know where I'm going. In this game, Vice City, I know more or less where I'm going more often than not, but get rid of that GPS point. There we go. But I've not played Vice City for a long time.
Happy, Holmes.
Now I think you can crash this car. Roll it, as long as you get another one and don't kill. Yeah, they're in Angel Pine. Okay. Oh, I should have listened to the helmet. I generally thought the dialogue was going to continue, but basically, it's something like we could catch them up or something. Yeah, I think we carry on. Yeah, okay. Like I said, I know more or less where I'm going. Okay, the GPS has kicked in, finally. I usually take the motorway, but I'll just follow the GPS. Oh. I tell you, I have really enjoyed playing this again. It's been a really good thing. Not really had any problems since the first couple of days. As long as you keep your gameplay, your fidelity, set that off and put performance on, you're pretty much set on it. Whoa. I mean, I know I'm all over the place myself, but what's up? Besides the point. So basically, when we get here, we're going to take some photographs of, for frig's sake, of people that are providing the yay to Big Smoke and Ryder, and then find information about them. Okay, so that's where Truce Farm. We're going past Truce Old Farm. These bits of the roads are really distracting. Just the random bits just sticking out of the road. See them every now and again. Why is there so much traffic today as well? Go on the fair list drive, my god. It's bloody long enough as it is. Just keep on going. Like I said, I believe if you flip his car, you'll still have, you can still, as long as you don't kill him, you can still use different cars. I know this because I've done it in the past. Or if he smokes or starts, or blows up, or whatever, I've done it in the past, so I know these things. At least that's what it's like in old games. I don't know if it's changed. I don't intend on finding out. Okay, checkpoint save. Okay, we've not got one yet, so we're going to get a camera in a minute. I think Caesar's going to give us one. Yep, there we go.
There it is, Holmes.
Okay. There's Ryder. Okay, so this is T-Bone Mendez. He's gonna get out of the car now.
This guy take himself real serious.
And then I believe it's Torino. Who's voiced by James Woods.
Hey, who's the gringo?
And then this is Jizzy.
It's a serious
organization. The pimp.
That was some heavy shit.
We better split up and get out of here. I'll meet you back at the garage, eh?
Coolio, we got what we came for anyway.
Right. So we got ourselves a camera. So we're in Angel Pine currently. Oh, we know all about the snapshots. They will be coming soon. They will be coming after these videos out. So, as you have probably well aware by now, I am doing like a videos, and then on my non-video days I am doing collectibles. So after this I didn't actually notice that. I know where I'm going, what am I doing? I want to go over here because there is a dirt bike over here. There's a Sanchez. It's always parked here. This is where we first came into the countryside. But there's always one parked here. Where our safe house was when we came into the country. Okay, I really butchered that jump. I don't know how that happened. What was I saying? I was saying something, I can't remember what I was on about. Oh, what was I talking about? I don't know. It'll come to me in a second. What did I do this? I forget that I start talking off on a tangent and I completely forgot what I was on about. Some little shortcuts. Oh yeah, the snapshots, there we go, just remembered. So basically there's 50 snapshots and they will be coming out next as part of the activities and collectibles guide, because I'm not sure if we'll be out of San Fierro by the end. So obviously I'm posting 12 videos a week. I do 2 to 3 missions per video, depending on how long we take. So I put out, so it depends on how far we get, if we can get to the oysters or not yet. Why have I come this way? Fucking hell. Can I? Yep, I can squeak on through here onto the train tracks and up here. But yeah, so there's 50 snapshots. I plan on releasing all 50 next week. So it'll be a Sunday, Monday, or the Tuesday, along with some activities. That is the plan. Okay, let's do this mission.
Hey, man, you get them flicks developed? What's up, Woozie?
Hey, Carl. I was just explaining to your brother-in-law that we were friends.
Oh, yeah? Well, look, Woozie, I need to get some info from you, man.
What exactly do you boys want to know?
Who are these putas, Holmes?
Why don't you go take a look?
These guys?
Yeah.
They're the Loco Syndicate. They're pretty big time, I think. Don't have any dealings with them. We don't touch blow. Now, this guy runs things. I don't know his name. This guy is T-Bone Mendez. He's the muscle.
And who's that guy?
That's Jizzy B. He's the biggest pimp in town. He helps set up the deals. You know, concierge of sorts.
Hey, did he my way in? How I get to him?
Oh, Jizzy? Jizzy runs the Pleasure Domes Club in that old fortress under the Gant Bridge.
Hey, good looking out, Woozie.
No problem. Don't be a stranger.
All right.
Oh. Okay. Right, so we're gonna head to Jizzy. So Jizzy is the what looks like a blue skull. So we've not been, but this area we're about to go to now, we've not been to yet. But yeah, it was a pretty nice place in the classic versions. Hopefully it's still the same. But yeah. Go underneath this bridge. Okay. If you see random purple shines in San Fierro at night, that's actually an indication that there is a photo there. So be on the lookout if you see them. That's what they are. It's not a glitch or anything, that is generally what it is. Well, in the old classic versions, it used to just flash in the middle of the night. But now it's purple for gleams. It was like the same with the oysters. They give off white orbs in the ocean.
Jizzy B?
Well, now that you mention it, I do have a slight problem. Something a little dumb muscle like yourself might be able to fix. Cause you see me, I'm intellectual. Bitches, y'all walk on down to the bar and fix a pimp drink. See, I only got two eyes, and in these streets, you got to have more than that. You got to be like a flying shit, you know? 100 eyes everywhere. Now some lunatic been fucking with my bitches. Motherfucker killed 2 last week. I want you to go find out.
No problem. You're my player partner now, Jizzy.
Wait up! Mr. C to the J! See that pretty young thing in my car? Got for off at the hotel downtown. Use my car phone and give me a ring a ding when you're done. And watch the rims, player. Treat that baby like a Pope mobile.
Okay, this could be, again, a bit of a pain in the ass to do. So, a little thing about Jizzy, he is actually voiced by, I don't remember his name, his full name, but it's Eddie Murphy's, he's either his brother or his cousin, but he's related to Eddie Murphy. I'm doing this mission, I believe. It unlocks them. I don't know if it unlocked them before, but it unlocks pimping missions. So, you just to get in a car like this and do them. I'll be doing an activity guide anyway on it. It's something I didn't really do when I played this game, so it'd be a new experience for me. So same with some of the stadium missions as well. We've not done those yet. I didn't do them either. Oh, they're very, very little of them, so be interesting.
Hey Jizzy, it's Carl. I just dropped off your girl.
Church. Got a little errand for you to run before you deal with that problem I was just talking about. Some young buck thinks he's a player, been trying to peel my holes over in Hashville. Now one of my girls over there just eyeballed the punk. I want you to get your ass over there and ice that pretender.
Oh yeah, there's a time. Okay, we got checkpoint saved. I wonder if we get one every time we do an installment, because there's like three or four different little missions within this mission, if you know what I mean. So be interesting to see how this works. At least there's a bloody checkpoint here, because I sometimes get lost around here. Oh no, actually, that's not actually too bad, actually. Okay. Yeah. No, we should be on the sidewalk here. You can either kill him or run him over, just don't kill.
Here comes my player, now you in real trouble.
I was pimpatry in motion till you showed up.
There we go, finally.
Hey, it's CJ. Just to let you know, you don't have to worry about no competition in Hashbury.
Worry? Did I say I was worried? No, I did not. Now to the real deal. Some of my girls in the Foster Valley been getting knuckle old. I want you to get your ass up there, nose around. Find out what's going on.
Okay. So this one, I think there's a couple of guys, like you said, like knuckling them down. Whoopsie, oh dear, oh that was a mistake by me. I didn't really damage my car though, thankfully. But they're underneath the highway bridge, not on it. So just in case as well, you're playing the old games, but the underneath are right here. A checkpoint save here, good, because this one you're effectively in like a drive-by here, and yeah, it's that way, isn't it? And that way, okay. And yeah, it's L1 to shoot. I was just checking. I've not done many drive-bys, so okay, we can't go across there yet. Please don't. I'm come around this side, because they go from this side, so if I go the other way, I'll be facing the runway. So he'll have protection. So this is the guy you want to kill in the limo, but he'll have, he has protection here as well. But he eventually crashes his car. So don't worry, just if you don't get him. Right. Now. Yeah, it goes. So don't worry about. Oh, God. Yeah, it was a bit of a. Just, like I said, they'll end up crashing eventually, so. If you don't get to them, so it's a bit congested here. Plus the fact I keep forgetting to, because usually, obviously, it was X to drive and square to brake, and then it was R2 and L2 to look left and right, but now obviously L2 and R2 are to whoa, I got him. I got the bloody thing. So yeah, at least I've got rid of him, the protection. Oh, he flips it. Come on, we can get to the bottom. Oh, he's on fire. Dumb.
Everything's been taken care of, Mr. Jizzy.
Oh, CJ, you can play his right hand, baby. Oh, and by the way, that car just come up over on the APB. Dump it, keep it, whatever. Just keep it away from me, my hoes, and my club.
Oh, for sure, you got that, man.
Oh, I'm right by a paint spray. Okay. We just go to this paint spray. Alright, and there we are. Right, so that is where we're going for today. The next video, we will be doing the car school. That will be an entire video because it's like 10 or 12 like missions, or it might be 8, I don't know. 8, 10, 12, it's one of those. So that is where we're going for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more videos like this, please like, subscribe to my channel. Also hit that bell icon for future video updates like this. And I'll see you all later. Bye bye.